Welcome to the Abyss. I'm Jacqueline, and today we're in the field exploring seaweeds in the intertidal zone. Let's dive in. The first seaweed you often come across in the intertidal zone is different species of the green algae, Alva. Alva likes really high levels of sunlight and can survive in lower salinities compared to other seaweeds. Because of this, Alva is found high in the intertidal zone and even above the high tide mark in tide pools such as this one. Alva can also survive in high nutrient and polluted areas and high temperatures. One interesting thing about Alva is that most species are only a single or two cell layers thick. The most common seaweeds found in the intertidal zone are the brown seaweeds. They are referred to as rockweeds. This is because they attach to the substrate using their holdfasts. Rockweeds are important and provide many ecological services, the most obvious of which is they add to the structural complexity of the habitat. They house many different creatures, such as barnacles, periwinkles, and crabs. They provide a moist, cool place for these creatures to live in for when the tide goes out. This helps these animals to survive desiccation. They also provide a good food source for many different animals. Many common rockweed species are those found in the genus Fucus. Fucus seaweeds tend to be smaller than other rockweed species and are a maximum length of about 20 to 30 centimeters. They grow much more quickly than other species and are able to colonize areas with much higher wave action. One species that is commonly found here is Fucus vesiculosus. It is easy to identify because it has paired air bladders. The species that dominates most intertidal areas is Ascophyllum nodosum. It is commonly referred to as knotted rack. It is distinguishable by its long, narrow, strap-like blades. It is much slower growing compared to the Fucus species and is unable to colonize in areas with high wave action. Because of this, in newly forming habitats, it is usually the Fucus species that are first to grow, followed by the Ascophyllum nodosum. However, Ascophyllum nodosum is much longer lived and over time becomes the dominant species. When you hear the term seaweed, it kind of implies that it grows really quickly. However, this is a bit of a misnomer with Ascophyllum nodosum, which grows really slowly. This species only grows a few centimeters per year. Another interesting thing about Ascophyllum nodosum is that it grows one air bladder per year. This means that you can count the number of air bladders along a blade to determine how old it is. As you can see, Ascophyllum nodosum can grow really long. This is because it is so long-lived and it has been found that it can live up to 2 decades. The red seaweeds tend to be found lowest in the intertidal zone and are only exposed at the very lowest tides a few times a month. One species common to this area is Chondrus crispus, or commonly referred to as Irish moss. That's it for our seaweed series. I hope you enjoyed it, and if there's any other series you'd like to see, let us know in the comments down below. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any content, and until next time, I will see you later.